Hey, what's up? John Sonmez here from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question about joining a company and not getting paid for a year. It was actually called accept a job with no pay for a whole year. And before you think this is a little bit crazy, let me read you the question. This is from Sammy. I think it's probably Sammy. And he says, does it make sense to work for a startup that will not pay me anything for a whole year, but promises equity? I would be the only technical founder. A nice short and sweet question. So you guys, when you ask me questions, you should ask a nice, simple question that I can read easily, and then you're more likely to get a response or a video created. So, you know, this is definitely one of those things where I have a pretty strong opinion on. Well, first of all, you got to think about joining a startup sort of like a lottery ticket, okay? There's a high probability that you're going to lose. More than likely you're going to lose, right? When you think about it, right, if you were, let's say, an investment banker, right, or a venture capitalist, okay, you would not put all your money into one startup. Why? Because you know that you're probably gonna lose the money, right? That's why it's a highly risky thing to do. What do VCs do? Okay, besides picking good companies, I mean, they go through that process. They take, maybe they have $10 million, right, to invest, and they put $1 million in 10 different companies, okay? Because they're expecting that one of those companies, when it hits big, it's gonna return them $100 million or $50 million, but they're expecting to lose $9 million on the other ones, right? And sometimes they lose all 10. So if you think about it, right, always think about it from the perspective of the wisest guy in an industry, or the person who either has the most to risk or most to lose, right? And that's the person who's bankrolling the operation. They got the money. So what are they doing and what are they betting on? So if they don't think that any particular company is going to survive, right? If they're never so sure, right? Have you ever heard of a VC just taking $100 million investing in one company, that's it, and they're just betting it all on that, everything they got? It doesn't happen, right? So if they don't think that it's a good idea, you shouldn't either. But that doesn't mean you shouldn't necessarily take this job. So here's the thing, this is what I'm talking about here. Don't take the deal on the promise of equity, and don't assume that what's gonna happen is that you're gonna work for a year, you're gonna build up equity in this company, you're not gonna get paid, and it's gonna be this huge, great investment, and then you're gonna make millions of dollars. Chances of that happening, maybe less than 1%, right? I mean, let's be honest here. Maybe you think it's more, it doesn't matter. It's nowhere, it's not even close to 50-50%. Let's put it that way. It's not even close to 50-50%. You can execute correctly, you can do everything right, you can have a perfect team and still fail in the business world, right? There's a certain matter of luck involved as well in a company doing well, a startup really going crazy, okay? So too many people have lost their dreams and hopes on that. But again, I'm not gonna say that you shouldn't take the job, but if you do take the job, here's why you take the job: for the experience, for the apprenticeship, right? So you need to evaluate this not in terms of what am I gonna make? How much money am I gonna make? Am I gonna become rich? Because there's no such thing as get rich quick, right? It's not gonna happen, right? You're not gonna, you know, work this one job and then assume that you're gonna become rich from this, right? That's the wrong attitude to have. And you'll be shooting for, you'll be not getting the best out of the experience. But here's the thing, okay? If this is a good opportunity, right? If this is something where you wanna see what it's like to work for a startup, you wanna, you know, get that experience, and maybe you wanna start your own startup someday, right? Or this is your dream. You wanna keep on working for startups, and maybe you're gonna work for them for a year at a time, or whatever it is, or even it's a specific technology, right? Maybe then you wanna take the job, right? So, you know, again, we have to separate the two, right? As far as like, should you join a startup in order to get equity because you're gonna make a big payday later on? No, absolutely not. Not a good investment, right? Doesn't make sense at all, okay? You can, if you were a VC and you could invest in 10, that's fine, but there's only one of you, okay? So that's one decision, right? Is on the company and the lottery ticket there. And the second decision is the job itself, right? And so that's why I say, like, I would take a job, right? For example, I've said this multiple times in videos. If Warren Buffett says, hey, or some billionaire says, hey, John, you know what? You know, I'm not gonna pay you anything, but you can hang around with me all day and you can get me coffee. I'll be like, fuck that. I'm going to drop everything I'm doing, right? I'm going to camp out on Warren Buffett's lawn and say, you know, and bring him coffee. You see what I'm saying? Like, because I'll learn so much because the experience is so valuable. So that's the thing, is you got to separate and say, okay, is the experience valuable, right? So I'm not saying never take a job that doesn't pay you anything, right? You should do that if the experience is worth it. It's just got to be really worth it to you, right? If it's not, then yeah, I'm all for negotiating. You know, in my book, by the way, The Complete Software Developer's Career Guide, you can check it out here. I talk about how to negotiate a job, how to get your best salary, right? So I don't want you to think that I'm talking about working pro bono and that I don't think you should get paid for your work, but you gotta weigh it out, right? You wanna always play the long game, right? What's always gonna benefit you the most in the long term, okay? And that's what you wanna think about this. So, you know, my opinion is, unless this is just a great job and just a great opportunity and you're willing to work without pay and not get equity, assume that the company's going to go to bust. If you assume that the company's going to bust and that year would be worth it to you for your career and for experience or getting close to someone who has been really successful that you're going to learn a lot from, then do it. But if not, then skip this, right? Don't be so desperate as to just take a job on equity. It's a crazy move, and it might work, right? I mean, you might be the one that proves me wrong, but 99% of the time, more than 99% of the time, you're just gonna lose everything and lose a year and not get paid for it. So yeah, that's my opinion on that. So if you like this video, by the way, you can always email me and I'll answer your question at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And make sure you click the subscribe button below. Click the bell to make sure that you don't miss any videos that I do here on the channel. I do like 2 to 3 videos a day. I'll talk to you next time. Take care.